A very good morning. I welcome you all to Mini IOCON 2021. And I thank the organizing committee for giving me a chance to present the case here. PPT is not showing. Okay. So my topic is spinal fusion, when, why, and how. I am Dr. Amit Jain, Associate Professor in Department of Orthopedics at SMS Medical College. Spine fusion surgery is to fuse two or more vertebrae into one single structure. And the goal is to minimize back pain and prevent instability. There are many indications for spine fusion surgery, and we'll be discussing them one by one. The first is spine instability. Stability as per White and Punjabi is the ability of a spine under physiological loads to limit patterns of displacement so as not to damage or irritate the spinal cord and nerve roots. Instability is excessive displacement of the spine that would result in neurologic deficit, deformity, or pain. The instability can be obvious or occult, and to identify occult instability, dynamic x-rays are important. Spondylolisthesis. There are many classifications for listhesis. Wiltse describes spondylolisthesis as 5 types: degenerative, isthmic, traumatic, dysplastic, and pathologic. Out of these, degenerative and the isthmic type of spondylolisthesis are encountered most commonly in our clinical practice. They may be associated with spinal canal stenosis, facetal arthritis, and instability. And they need adequate decompression and stabilization and fusion with or without correction of listhesis. Spinal canal stenosis may be associated with collapsed disc height, foraminal stenosis, and facetal flexion. Patient may present with back pain and claudication symptoms, and they need foraminal height restoration with anterior interbody fusion. Deformity in spine, kyphosis, and scoliosis. They require osteotomies and instrumentation to achieve correction. The instrumentation, whenever done, requires fusion or the implant will eventually fail. Infective spondylodiscitis. They present with mechanical back pain, which will be very severe in nature, with or without neurological involvement. And decompression done alone in such situation will increase instability in an already unstable condition. They almost always need instrumented interbody fusion with debridement, and kyphotic collapse may need anterior reconstruction and fusion with posterior instrumentation. Here is a case of L4-5 spondylodiscitis with disc space involvement and paradiscal involvement, and such cases need interbody fusion. And there is one more case, D10-11 Cox, which presented with paraparesis and collapse after laminectomy done alone. So in such cases also anterior reconstruction and instrumented fusion is required. Fractures. Fractures with flexion destruction or translational injury pattern. Fractures associated with posterior ligamentous complex injury and other unstable fractures, they require instrumented fusion. We need to identify the occult signs of instability in such cases like PLC injury. And if we fail to fuse these cases, ultimately they'll end up into collapse and implant failure. Revision surgery. Cases like recurrent disc herniation, adjacent segment degeneration, they are associated with back pain, claudication symptoms, instability, and deformity. And we may need to decompress widely here, and which will further lead to instability, and hence fusion is required in most of the revision surgery cases. There is one case illustration. Patient underwent L3 to L5 fusion. And after a few years, patient presented with L2-3 instability and L2-3 stenosis. So L2-3 had to be incorporated into the fixation and fused. There are other extended indications like tall dehydrated disc in heavy individual or manual labor, a big central disc, which may sometimes be not possible to be dealt with decompression alone. And sometimes we need to do interbody fusion in such cases. Sagittal facets, in which post decompression they are more prone for instability and listhesis, so they require fusion. Facetal effusion and arthritis, and predominant back pain in patient presenting with some other spine complaint, they tend to go for fusion. Traction osteophytes and vacuum phenomena, that is gas in the disc. These are occult signs of instability and require fusion. And modic changes. These patients present with back pain and it won't go without fusion. Now, lumbar fusion. How to do fusion? So in lumbar spine, fusion can be done posterior lateral fusion, that is intertransverse fusion, or interbody fusion. Interbody fusion could be PLIF, that is posterior lumbar interbody fusion, TLIF, transforaminal lumbar interbody fusion, or OLIF, that is oblique, and ALIF, that is anterior lumbar interbody fusion. Now, in intertransverse fusion, the tips and tricks are that expose laterally till the tips of transverse process, prepare the transverse process well, and even the lateral wall of facets, even before you put the screws, and put lots of bone graft so that post-operatively you see a union as seen in this illustrative X-ray. You should see good fusion masses. In interbody fusion, the steps are after the exposure and pedicular screw fixation and decompression, nerve root release, and facetectomy, which is in TLIF. Disc space is prepared. We need to do a subtotal or near complete discectomy and prepare the end plates well. That is the key to a proper, a good interbody fusion. Scrape properly with the curettes and insert bone graft first anteriorly in the disc space and then insert case. Then we need to compress over the screws so as to achieve good bone, good contact. And post-operatively in a year or so, we see a good fusion mass. So the take-home message is identify the indications properly and fusion surgery, if done in a good indicated case with proper bone mass preparation, like lateral transverse process preparation and disc space preparation, will lead to good results. Thank you.